everybody, and welcome to today's video. And in today's video, we will be doing part 22 of our A Closer Look At series, where we take a closer look at every state's national and statewide races and whatnot. And in today's video, we will be doing the state of Florida. Kind of a battle, or definitely a battleground state, voted twice for Obama, for Bush, and for Trump. On my presidential map, it's a lean. It's fairly close. Of course. But Joe Biden has about 2 1/3 odds, which makes it a lean on my thing. A recent A-plus pollster actually has Trump winning, but a more recent A-plus pollster actually has Biden winning. And you go look at the polling averages. Joe Biden only leading by 1.9 in Florida. His lead often changes, but it typically hovers around the 2-4 mark, which is, I think, enough to make it a lean on my map. The House election. This is one of those few states where I will be using notes because there's so many districts. First off, the first and second districts are both solid red districts. This little district up here, that's the fifth, is a solid blue. The fourth, solid red. The third, solid red. The sixth, solid red. The 11th is another solid red district. The 12th is solid red. The 13th, though, and actually the 14th, are both solid blue. The 15th district is a likely, if we go back here, we go look at Florida's 15th district. About 8 in 10 odds, which is enough to make it likely, I guess. A little less, and it would probably be more, fitting, and there's not exactly a lot of polling here. The most recent is only a C. They have Franklin up by 8. I think that this, honestly, could be a solid red district, but I think it's better as likely, although both work. If it was 5-3, and 100 odds more for the Democrat, it would probably be more of a solid at being a likely, but it's not, which makes it a little questionable. So yeah, that's the, what district was that? The 15th district. Over here we have 3 solid blue in the 9th district, the 10th district, and the 7th district. This little district, the 8th, is a solid red district. Same with the 18th and the 17th. Oh, also the 16th. A lot of red districts. And the 19th and the 25th. So a lot of red districts over there. But essentially every other district over here is a solid blue district. So it's a fairly, you can see like the geographically, but it's a fairly mixed area. Clearly it looks like Republicans control more land. I've talked about this before though. Typically the Democratic areas will be more focused in one spot, while the Republican areas are in widespread but less people. So yeah, you can clearly see the little Democratic bits with the Republican. And there's a lot more Democratic areas in these, or counties in these smaller little areas. But that's actually it for Florida, because then you don't have a gubernatorial or Senate race. So that's actually the end of Florida. And the reason that we haven't really looked much into this, because there's really, like, Florida is the type of state where on the House map, it's going to be fairly safe, but on a presidential map, it's going to be a legit toss-up, because Florida's House races are, like I said, they're very Republican areas and very Democratic areas, which leads to a more of a toss-up status. In fact, it's very much like that in California, but the only thing is, there are Democratic areas, California has such a large population, that even though there is a very, very large amount of people that are going to vote red, I'm still going to vote blue because even though there's so many conservatives in California, it has that many more liberals because it has such a large population. In fact, I think I saw somewhere, this might be wrong, but Florida or California actually had the highest popular, or the most people, popular vote-wise, that voted for Trump in 2016. I might be wrong, but I think I heard that somewhere. But yeah, that's the end of the state of Florida. Florida's on here. I think that a tilt makes sense. A likely could make sense. Tilt red could make sense. A tilt or a lean red, maybe. Anything that's likely does not make sense. Same thing with the safe. But I think that the least likely of those four that I just showed that could make sense is a lean red. I doubt that could actually work. But yeah, that's the end of the video. So thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe. Stay tuned for next video, which will be the state of Georgia, a typically conservative state that has turned into a battleground. So yeah, once again, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you there. Bye!